the craft room with Paige, who just heard from one of our viewers, of course, Alice Morgan, who wants to create her own crafting table. So here to show us how to do it.
And
take it away.
I think it starts with organization when you have a craft room.
Right, like you said.
Because otherwise it's just going to be a whole bunch of stuff. Yes. So if you look at this entire craft room, there's some hidden gems on how to get organized, and we shall start with the table.
Okay, we start with the table.
Yeah, this is a great job redoing this, by the way.
Oh my gosh, it's so much fun. And it doesn't hurt the brain. You know, there's nothing worse than going into a messy room, and you also buy more things because you can't find it.
True.
Okay.
Spoken from a true crafter.
And then you can't focus.
Oh, but here's what I love about this is everything that you see that's going to be making up this table, they're pre-made, pre-cut. You don't have to do anything.
No cuts at all going into this thing.
No cuts. You just have to put it together like a puzzle.
That's great news for somebody like me who doesn't feel so safe using a saw.
Yes.
I'm not very comfortable using a saw, so this is a project for me. So what do we need besides, it looks like a power drill?
Yes. We've got the drill. We've got a couple of bookcases. You can get these at any, you can get them at hardware stores and at furniture stores.
Okay. And it doesn't matter. They're not, you know, not specifically any kind, whatever you got. Okay, good.
Because you can measure them and do the rest of the measurements to that. So then we have plywood behind you.
Right.
This lovely little thing is actually a foot or a table leg. And then we need butcher block. And the great thing about that too, with the plywood and the butcher block, you can tell them what size you need. It is cut for you.
Oh, nice.
And you just,
and you just have to assemble it. All right, let's start with the plywood here. We'll bring it out front.
Yep.
Now, as people can see, this has been pre-painted white to match the bookcases.
Yep, let's show the back.
Okay, there you go.
I didn't do that. It's waste because you're never going to see that. But the sides you're going to see and maybe a little bit of the bottom. And since I have white, I painted that white. If you have a different color, go with that. And now I'm going to add the table legs.
So this is the last leg.
This is the last.
It's on its last leg.
It's on its last leg.
Literally.
Doesn't have a leg to stand on.
So it actually has nine.
Yeah, it has nine. So I did nine, and what I love about these is you can see that I'm screwing them in, and depending on whether or not you have an old home, maybe not some floors that are so even. You know, it's nothing worse than getting to a restaurant and you get like
the table that's wiggled.
And you have to
it'd be
underneath.
Worse for your craft table.
It'd
that's
be
for
so
sure.
So bad for your
craft
table.
Yeah, of course it would.
So these are adjustable, and also if you want to raise the height a little bit, you can do that as well.
Okay, and you could put wheels instead of legs as well if you want.
Yes.
It's something that you need to move around the room.
And I actually did that, and I'll show you in a minute.
Okay.
Okay. So let's set this down.
Got
this is our base. Let's see right there.
Right in here.
Even.
Okay.
Good.
Then time for the bookcases.
These are the bookcases.
I love getting involved, Paige. You know that.
I know. I'm going to use your muscle.
So they can be any kind of bookcases, but they have to be the same.
Yeah, two of the same.
Two of the same.
It would be, it'd be very nice. So, okay, now I'm going to hand you this one over there. We're going to set that down. Now, what we are going to do, it's on that base. We're not going to screw them to each other. We're going to screw them to the base. Okay, we good there? We're nice and flush.
Now, can I ask you what kind of screws are actually going to be big enough to go into this?
I used, down below, I used a half-inch screw. Because basically you want to make sure that you're not going all the way through the plywood. So I put screws down below here. And then for the top that we're going to see in a second, I went under and did like this.
Gotcha.
So they're not actually connected here at all. The base is what's keeping
connected.
Connect
to the base, connect to the butcher block on top, and that way it's all locked
in. That way, yes, it's perfect.
Okay, good. On that note, let's do the butcher block.
Let's
do it.
This is beautiful, by the way, that butcher block.
And what I love about this is you measure whatever size table you need. It looks so impressive, I was gonna let you
really
do it yourself.
Well, I don't like to brag.
You don't like to brag, but you will. Okay. So then we just make sure that it is good on either side. And again, you want this to be clean.
Yes.
So you're going to take your screws and go underneath. Just make sure you don't get too big because you don't want it coming through the top at all.
And I'd like to emphasize the point that the size of your butcher block can be pre-ordered depending on the size of your bookcase.
Exactly.
Which is
to cut.
Yes. But doesn't it look so custom?
It looks beautiful, but it's also very functional. And that's the whole point of trying to keep it organized in your craft room. The amount of space down here is super impressive.
You could probably fit in one of these cubbies.
You know what?
Should we try?
Maybe I could.
Maybe not. Okay, so if you could, Debbie, come on over here and help me. Let's fill this. If you could hand us stuff.
I'll start with the bag. basket.
Okay, those go down below.
Just to give people an idea of how much can fit into something like this.
Oh my gosh, that's
thank you.
They're the perfect size.
Yes.
We've got those on that side, of course, and now we've got all of our fabric.
Our fabric. This is beautiful.
All right, we've got our beautiful, colorful, different types of fabric.
Oh my gosh, this is Orly and Ken's dream come true right now.
Seriously.
This is how Home and Family's craft room came to be. I mean, look how great this is looking already.
This is so beautiful.
Well, I've got the tough job here, you know, by the way.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, you really do.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you go. Take the blue.
Talking about the size dimensions of the table that that you're making here, Paige, it doesn't necessarily, of course, have to be this. Instead of using two bookcases, you could just use one.
You know what's really exciting is look around the room. Yeah. We've got one over there that's a half. We've got ones behind you that are a couple different sizes. We did one over here on, as you said.
That's nice.
The rollers.
Oh, there's the wheels.
The casters. Now look how cool. Remember in our last craft room, sometimes we had an L-shaped table? Well, look at this. I'm gonna come over by you guys. You put that together. We call this an L-shape.
Doesn't just look fantastic, also super functional.
Yep, so this could be on casters too. If you use your craft room for anything else, you can move everything out of the way and it still looks awesome. And
dare I say, this is now my favorite room in the whole house.
It's so fun.
It really is. That's so beautiful.
And let me tell you, for resale, I know you guys, I'm always thinking about flipping properties.
We're not selling this house.
Darn it, I'll take it off the market. But if you have these, I mean, it looks so custom and so built in, it raises your property value.
Really?
Yes. So stick with this, and you guys will make some money.
And if you were going to try to buy this in a furniture store,
that's the best point. And all we did is put a puzzle piece together.
This is beautiful.
I love it. Thank you so
much. Well done.
Thank you.
Very, very well done. It was fun to be involved, let me tell
you. Now don't touch anything in here.